Effective April 9th, the U.S. Federal Reserve introduced the Main Street New Loan Facility Program. It's eligible for borrowers with businesses with up to 10,000 employees or up to $2.5 billion in 2019 revenue that have been created and organized in the U.S. with significant operations in and a majority of employees based in the U.S. The companies can also participate in the PPP programs and also the Economic Injury Disaster Loan programs. However, they may be restricted from participating in any other U.S. Federal Reserve program, so you need to check if you're participating in one of those programs before you apply for this loan. The loan features are as follows. It's a four-year maturity. It's unsecured. Deferral of amortization of principal and interest for 1 year. Adjustable rate based on secured overnight financing rates, which is almost essentially zero, plus 250 basis points to 400 basis points. The minimum amount of the loan is $1 million. The maximum loan is the lesser of $25 million or an amount when added to existing outstanding debt and committed but undrawn debt does not exceed 4 times 2019 EBITDA. So if you thought the tax law was kind of complicated, this loan is also kind of complicated. But essentially, it's basically driving companies that are having difficulty obtaining traditional financing, but reflect sufficient cash flow to service the additional debt if they receive it. There's no prepayment penalty, cannot refinance or prepay existing debt, cannot cancel or reduce existing lines of credit, must have been impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. And finally, the companies must make a reasonable effort to maintain its payroll and retain employees during the term of the loan. I'm now going to pass it on to my partner, Mitzi Hollenbeck.
Thanks, Will. I appreciate it. And certainly, we don't actually have a slide related to the PPP program and the EIDL program because the majority of this webinar is focused on the tax provisions in the CARES Act. But we wanted to give you an update. We certainly have done other external webinars related to the PPP program and the EIDL program, and we'll continue to keep you informed and updated. You can always check our COVID-19 response website so that you can get up-to-date information related to the latest releases related to these programs. So just by way of a quick introduction as to what has changed in the past 24 hours for the most part, because every day seems to be a new acknowledgement of something happening or interpretation related to these particular loan programs. Just yesterday, what happened was we had another release of a new interim final rule, which kind of clarified a little bit of the information that existed out there with regard to sole proprietors and partners in partnerships related to their eligibility and the calculation of total maximum allowable payroll for purposes of the calculation of the PPP grant. So yesterday, within that guidance, specifically, it allowed for partnerships with general active partners are able to have up to $100,000 of their self-employment income included in the partnership loan application. The interim final rule also clarifies how to calculate the payroll amount required or allowed for a Schedule C or sole proprietor in those particular, I won't say they're frequently asked questions, it's just another final, an interim final rule. Some of the other major changes that have happened in the past week related to the EIDL program, there actually was a letter that was issued on April 10th, 2020, it was from the U.S. Chamber of Commerce to Congress, really asking and trying to clarify some of the information with regard to the SBA guidance on the EIDL program, which previously allowed loans up to $2 million. We haven't seen this necessarily published in authoritative guidance yet to really show that the EIDL program has kind of come to a little bit of a halt right now. We're not sure when the applications that have already been submitted to the SBA may be impacted by this guidance, but it appears as though the SBA is somewhat rationing the maximum amount of these loans. We also know that what happened in the past week is that the EIDL advance grant, which is provided for in the CARES Act, which used to be a $10,000 grant, which was forgivable if you applied for the EIDL, you were denied the EIDL, or you applied for the PPP and the EIDL advance grant, you could use it as part of the offset to the PPP loan forgiveness. Well, that was clarified and changed to be a maximum of $1,000 per employee within your operations. So for this advance grant, but if you only have 3 employees within your organization, the maximum advance grant you can receive now is $3,000. Certainly, we're seeing a lot of banks that are coming up with they're almost on different time frames with regard to funding some of these loans. Some of the applications and the requirements with the banks are certainly different. And we are awaiting additional guidance related to the calculation. Really, you know, what we're just cautioning everybody on, and we will provide further guidance on the forgiveness calculations related to the PPP loans. These are loans of your business, and just be prepared with regard to your cash flow needs and your cash flow projections that this may be something that you may end up having a piece that is not forgiven. I do see one question that I can just answer on the air right now. It is related to a PPP loan question. It says if your payroll is paid twice a month and the period for measuring expenses for forgiveness is only 8 weeks, you know, what happens in that case due to your payroll dates? We hope that they'll clarify whether or not this will be cash basis or accrual basis on the payroll. We are not aware of what that guidance might look like, but certainly stay tuned.